and she got pregnant, and she left her mother, and her mother became my So I've been thinking about that. And I had story time. Well, yeah, yesterday. I was just basically chit-chat ramble. And I was talking about this lady. I had picked up this homeless lady. I sure did. She was homeless. I'm going to go ahead and put on my dark foundation. I picked up this homeless lady. I was on my way to the storage to pay for my storage. And I was sitting in my car. And I saw this lady walking. She kept going back. She walked. She had bags in her hands and she walked a little ways. And then she would sit the bags down. Then she would go back and get more bags. And then she would walk a little ways. And then she'd go back and get the last set of bags. And I was like, what is she doing? And then I saw her repeat the same thing again until she was getting closer to where I was at. So after I finished doing whatever I needed to do at the public storage, I asked her. I rolled down my window and I stood on like where she had to cross me. And I said, excuse me, you okay? You need a ride? And she said, yeah, I do need a ride. So she said, yeah, I do need a ride. I'm staying in a shelter. But I don't like the shelter because I went yesterday and they told me they couldn't let me stay and they didn't have room for me. And it's the only one that I can get to because I don't have a car and I have to keep carrying my bags everywhere and I don't have a shopping cart. She told me it was another shelter that she wanted to go to, which was down the road, down further. Like it wasn't like down the road, but you know, in a car it's not that far, but walking is a long way. So I told her I would take her. Out the way. So the shelter that was down the road didn't have no more room for her. They weren't taking in no one. And it's not where you can sleep outside and you can wait. So I started making phone calls trying to find her. Actually found a shelter that would help assist her because she was telling me that at this point she no longer had a job and she was completely alone. Thank you. left the Dollar Tree. We went to go grab something to eat, and I shared my lunch with her. And she was asking me where I stay at. So I told her where I stay at. She said, oh my God, I used to live there. And I was shocked. We lived in the same apartments. The same apartments. And this was like, this took place a few years ago. And she was telling me that, you know, she had a daughter. Her daughter came down to Texas with her. And Dad came down to make it to survive together. And I was telling her that I'm down here with my kids too. She told me she had a 36-year-old daughter. Surviving together. And I was telling her where I stayed up at the time, and she was like, well, I was on the other end of you, so that's probably why we never met or never why we never saw each other. So she was on the opposite ends of me. So I asked her, where was her daughter at? And she says she doesn't know. Her daughter has started a new life without her. I said, without you, what happened? And she told me that when they first got down here, they still struggle even after having a job, even when they put their money together for the rent. They still didn't really have money for food. So then, her daughter met a guy in Texas, and she started dating. And one day, her daughter told her that she was pregnant by the guy. And then she said she noticed that the guy used to always come by the house and stay the night at the house with her daughter. And then they started like staying the night out and stuff like that. And her daughter wasn't coming home. She said she didn't bother her daughter about her daughter not coming home because her daughter was grown, you know, and she was dating a guy she really liked it. Now I'm gonna jump and then I'm gonna come back to this part. After we found the shelter and they gave us the appointment, we went down there and they told her that they was giving her a room and they was gonna be able to assist her, and this shelter was gonna help her get clothes so that she could go on interviews. They was gonna help and assist her on finding a job, and they was gonna help her get an apartment. So I was really happy about that. She was ecstatic, and the shelter was like about 30-35 miles from where I was. So I drove all the way down here using up my gas. Shelter told her that her slot was going to be open, I think they said about between 7 and 9, and she could come back between 7 and 9, and just later on, I was telling my daughter, dang, I wish I would have had told her to just find somewhere to sit and wait for her time, because I took her with me back to go pick up my daughter, and then I had to take her back to the shelter. So by the time I was leaving her, my gas was on E. I lost a lot of gas helping her. But for some reason at that time, I just was like, okay, you could come with me and I'll bring you back. You know, so that's how it went. So when my daughter got off of work, we took her back down there. And she took all her bags, all her stuff inside the shelter. She was overly, overly happy. We was happy too. We were so happy. Even though my daughter was like, my daughter was freaking out because, you know, I had a stranger in a car, a homeless lady in a car with all her stuff. And then my daughter was like, Mom, what we gonna do about gas? Because that's the gas to get me to work for the rest of the week, you know? And I was telling my daughter, I'll figure it out. Which I didn't have no clue how I was gonna figure it out. On my way home, I felt good about that I helped her. I was really happy. And I told her that I hope I see her again or we cross each other path, you know, again. But I never seen her again till this day. I never seen a woman no more till this day. Because Houston is huge, okay? Houston is very, very big. Start on my eyeshadow. I think I'm gonna go with a pretty bronzy color inside the palette. I'm using the James Charles palette. I'm gonna go with this. Matter of fact, I think I'm gonna go with this real pretty peachy color. I think that'll be pretty. And I'm gonna do it all over the eye, on both eyes, as a base. Now, this lady was an older lady at the time. I was like 40 something years old. And this lady was like in her late 50s, maybe like 56, 57 at the time. She was telling me that she miss her daughter. She really miss her daughter, but she don't know when she gonna be able to see her daughter again. And she don't know how they gonna get back in communication. She was telling me that her daughter came home one day and told her that she was pregnant by the guy that she was dating. And the mother was real happy. She said she was so happy. She was so happy because that was her first grandchild. So her daughter came home one day, was telling her that her and the new guy that she's dating is going to be looking for a new apartment. Because they need a bigger space since she's pregnant. So they're going to be moving to a bigger apartment. And she said that the daughter said that they're going to have to take all of their money noticed that her daughter started staying out more and more and more. And she still didn't say nothing because, you know, she said her daughter said she would leave from work and go stay with her boyfriend. And she said one day she had to pay the rent. And she was waiting on her daughter to get home to get the money because they put their money together to pay the rent. And her daughter didn't come home. So then she called her daughter and she said, when you gonna be home, you know we gotta pay the rent. And the daughter answered the phone and said, well, I'll be home tomorrow. So then when the next day come, she kept calling her daughter. Her daughter wouldn't answer the phone. And the next day came and her daughter never showed up. So she said her daughter called her back on the third day. And she told her mother she's going to have to come up with the rent because they needed all of the money to be able to pay for the new place. So the mother said she didn't have the money to come up with all the rent. You know, why didn't she tell her something sooner? Because she don't know what to do. She done already, like, bought food for the house and she paid. Explain to them why she was late and that she was waiting on her daughter to give her her part. So she said one day she came home from work and the daughter boyfriend was outside waiting on her. Didn't bother her because her and her daughter didn't have a car. that she couldn't get overtime and that she was worried that she's not going to have to rent. She's going to end up getting, you know, evicted. They're going to end up getting evicted and it's going to mess up their record. So she said the daughter told her she'll see what she can do. So a couple of days pass after that and she calls the daughter to tell the daughter she needs the rent. And the daughter said that she's gonna have the boyfriend bring the rent over. So she said that when she got the letter from the office that they was late. She was late again, that she was gonna be evicted. So she went to the office and gave them the rent money that she had. And she called her daughter and said, tell your boyfriend when he bring the rent money, take it straight to the office. So she said she thought that he was taking it that day and she wasn't worried, so she went to work. And when she came home from work that next day, she had noticed that it was a notice on the door saying that basically that she needed to have the rest of the rent by a certain amount of day or she was going to be evicted and all of her stuff was going to be removed from the house. So then she started calling her daughter. And she said her daughter answered the phone and told her that she's going to have to find a way to come up with the rent money. That they need all the money to put towards the newer place. But, you know, and she told her daughter that she had already gave her part to the rent. And they're going to end up getting evicted. And she said the daughter told her, I'm going to call you back, Mom. once she got her stuff, they told her that she had to leave the premises. So she took her stuff and she said she waited outside of the apartments, hoping that her daughter drive by and come pick her up. And she said, before you know it, she was outside homeless. And she said she couldn't go to work because she didn't. All the stuff that she packed, all her clothes, all the stuff she packed, she couldn't take it on a bus with her. She said she put her clothes somewhere and she stayed outside near the apartments hoping that her daughter come looking for her. She said next thing you know, a week went past, her daughter never came. So then she started looking for like a shelter and she found a shelter, but it was hard to get in. She got to get in it a couple of times, but only a couple of times. And she said she kept calling her daughter, hoping her daughter answered the phone. And she said after 3 weeks, she realized that her daughter basically left her. She met a man. And she got pregnant, and she left her mother, and her mother became homeless. And now, she had been outside, living homeless, for almost 4 months. And she stayed near the apartments, hoping that her daughter come looking for her. She lost a lot of weight because she barely had food. Had no way to get food. And she basically just tried to, you know, find somewhere safe and link up with other homeless people to try to survive out there. And she said no one has never offered her any type of assistance or help until I came along. And then she said after a while, she lost complete contact with her daughter because she couldn't pay her phone bill, so her phone got cut off. Because she no longer had a job. And then she didn't feel comfortable with looking for a job because of hygiene, not having, you know, a place to sleep, a place to wash, a place to take care of herself. In some sad situations, they really do. And she told me she never thought in a million years that her daughter would leave her like that. And she said all the time she'd been out there, her daughter never came back looking for her. Never came back. So did she ever think she's gonna meet her grandchild? She told me no. But I remember when I was a young girl, I was young and I had my first child. I stayed in a shelter, and in the shelter, they assisted me or helping me find a job, and they helped me pay for my first apartment so that I could get on my feet. There are places out there where you only can get a meal or you can sleep, you know, lay your head. But there are also places out there that really do help you get back into the population, get back into society, and try to get back on your feet. There's different scenarios and different situations that happen to different people. But sometimes you can't help what happens to you. Some stuff you don't have no control over. Listening to me telling this story time, and you got resources. lipstick, this lip color, liquid lipstick. I don't know if it's a lip gloss or liquid lipstick. I got it from the Elements Cosmetics. I'm gonna use that today. Oh yeah, this is definitely a pretty color. This was definitely the perfect color. It's really, really gorgeous. I'm gonna let it dry and I'm gonna see how it dried. I'm gonna add a little bit more. Once again, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much for watching and listening. Yeah, this was kind of a sad story time, but I did bring it up in my chit chat and I was just thinking about the lady. I've never seen her again, but I'm hoping and praying in my heart that the shelter that she got to really, really helped her and really gave her assistance, and she was able to move forward on her life and she's doing well. And I'm also sending out love and light for those out there kind of going through a similar situation, maybe just trying to find, you know, help, or trying to not be homeless anymore, trying to get on their feet. And I pray, achieve that some way, somehow. Yes. Okay, try. Try before I cold. This is the finished look. Bye. Love and light. Bye, y'all.
Testing 1, 2, 1, 2.
It's been a long day, you just wanna go away. You can't sleep at night, and now I'm here. I can't promise tomorrow, but you're gonna feel out of day. We can tingle it away, now I'm here.